If anyone was going to take the reins over from Fan Zhendong in terms of a winner of this event, it seems like Wang Chuqin would be the most likely.
I agree with that. You know, you'll have seen what happened earlier. I'm sure that they'll have spoken. We can't have two of our top four players out in an afternoon. You need to make sure you go out and win this. Win it well, I guess. Also a little message.
Three, one.
Right off the edge there from Geraldo.
Nicely executed, Chiquita. That might have been the only thing that he hadn't have planned.
Wang Chuqin plays a beautiful Chiquita as well himself.
It's funny, Wang Chuqin wanted to be a Penhold player, but was told that his talent doesn't quite match up in that kind of way. And I understand it, because there is a rigidness to him.
Right.
I feel like he'd have to work very hard to get shots of flair. Whereas others, a.k.a. Charles Morrigard, probably didn't have to.
Flash, please.
But the thing is, he suffocates you in different ways.
I didn't know that about he was going to be a...
It's one of the great things for WTT doing it. They're showing player insight videos, interviewing the pros, and bridging the gap between fans and players.
Yeah, that's really good. I think the accessibility now to players is unprecedented, isn't it? In this day and age, really, it's a great time to be a sports fan. What are the strengths for you for Geraldo overall over the years that you've watched him?
I'd say he's got a very open style. If he gets to a loop-to-loop stage, he might even be able to compete at times with Wang Chuqin. But I think the serve-receive is the big question mark. Will he even be able to get out with that?
Four,
you can see
six.
He's struggling with the third balls. There's just that extra bit of quality coming in that you cannot replicate if you don't train with Wang Chuqin.
I think a lot of fans would love to see some loop-to-loops between these two. We just haven't got there yet, have we? We're not really having many rallies.
He's a good reader of spin. He's got a very good understanding of what's possible. Geraldo, he's someone who's openly said he loves trying out different equipments, reviewing different blades and rubbers. He knows how to beat Wang Chuqin, but it's a different thing trying to do
seven,
it. Miss serve there. In fact, it caught the edge,
Yep.
It's a real unreturnable serve.
Geraldo, they're just pointing that out. So fine, we can't capture it that easily.
Five, nine.
Portugal have got some great players, haven't they? Marcos Freitas and Thiago Apolonia. João Geraldo.
It's been the same old guys for so long.
Yeah, they... Definitely an experienced side, shall we say.
Yeah. Overall and together. They were European champions in Lisbon. 2014.
Six.
Even got a tweet from Cristiano Ronaldo, who's actually a table tennis fan himself. That win over Germany. But yeah, Freitas, Apolonia, Geraldo, Monteiro. They're the guys.
11,
Wang Chuqin right now. And recounter, or does he want to push long?
One, love.
It depends on whether he feels as though Wang Chi-Chin is a bit more uncertain in blocking heavy spin or countering a drive.
So, look, I know we're talking about completely different players here, but with Li Sang-soo against Lin Gao-yen, what did you think sort of is...
One,
that's why he's the world number two. Just look at that. In most cases, that would be a winner from Geraldo.
In 99.9%. What were you saying there, Shazam?
Yeah, so just going back, you know, what did Lee Sung-soo do earlier? I mean, that was a tremendous result. That can be a blueprint. Can it be a blueprint for others? Or is it just you have to take each match in its own individual right?
Each match on its own right, but in terms of the attitude required,
yeah,
definitely a blueprint. I mean, Lee Sung-soo is someone that basically every non-Team China player looks up to, as someone who's shown it's possible time and time again.
And we've talked about it many times. Part of it is the fearlessness, right?
It's the fearlessness.
And yesterday you kind of mentioned as well the phrase showing too much respect to an opponent.
It's an adversarial sport. I will win or you will win. And that brings about the accountability. You have to own it, even if you miss.
But you, hands up, that's all you, right? It's all on you.
There are a lot of other factors, such as moisture, flooring, the type of table and ball, but you can't blame it. It's the same for everybody.
Well, this is a good-looking rally. He was hanging in there for as long as he could, Geraldo.
Reverse pendulum serve, and Wang Chi-Chin can't play his crisp backhand. Showing some nice variations here, the Portuguese. Does very well on that third ball as well, because Wang only just tinted it. Nice length.
We look back at there was a certain vulnerability about Team China just a few weeks ago.
Wow.
And Geraldo is suddenly putting some really high level stuff here.
That was electric. Look at this. That's what I was talking about, the athleticism, the prowess. There is a certain aura of Zhao Geraldo that he's had even since he was a junior, and now he's 3 points ahead in this second. Oh, right off the bounce. That is just killer.
Yeah.
But to build upon your point from the world, Shazad, the last event Wang Chi-Chin played, he lost to Zhang Wujin.
Yeah. Well, this is what I was getting at. That he looked vulnerable for a little bit.
For a little bit. For a match.
But it also feels like a switch has come on for Zhao Geraldo. He's really up to gear, isn't he?
Left 7-5.
He's taking accountability. And now he's throwing the kitchen sink at Wang Chi-Chin.
Seven,
it either takes
six.
Something ultra aggressive, which actually seems more unlikely to be able to beat a Chinese, because that's exactly what they are and are best at. And almost invented in the modern game. Or something completely out of the box. He does level here, Wang Chi-Chin.
Well, he was trailing. He was in some trouble, wasn't he? And that's...
Shows you how confident he is that he doesn't need it. But at the same time, I mean, I would have, but that's only me, right?
Seven,
I mean,
eight.
Fair.
It's
a very personal decision, isn't it?
It's more than probable. It's probably the reality that they know something we don't.
Well, you're playing a player who's won 16 out of 17 matches in 2024.
9-7.
Wang Chi-Chin. But I tell you what, right off the bat, he's won two in a row. Geraldo.
Wang Chuqin's backhand isn't massively risky compared to a lot of European players, but what it has is the transfer of energy out in front. It's a short, snappy stroke, so sometimes you don't even really notice the risk because it's all so quick. I mean, look at that. How he calibrates that, how he coils it.
Well, as good a year as Wang Chuqin has had, it's not been great for his opponent. Geraldo has played 9 matches this year. He's only won 2 of the 9. So it's been tough. And would you believe it, having trailed for much of this second game, Wang Chuqin now has a game point.
That's a great receive. That is one hell of a receive from Zhao Geraldo. The angle that he made here with this forehand touch trapped Wang Chuqin for space.
Yeah, really nice return that.
Well, what is a good shot? What is the definition of a good shot? A good shot is a shot that really limits the options of the opponent. And that's exactly what both have shown in this second game.
Yeah, you're right. But it is Wang Chuqin again with a second game point here. Oh, we were asking about loop to loops here.
Just loving the coaching there from Xiao Zhan, the coach for Wang Chuqin, who's coached many legends such as Zhang Jike, Wang Manyu. He was so invested. He was so expressive that Wang Chuqin doesn't feel like he's on his own in this fight, and that is key in this 1v1 sport.
Love three.
I'm there with you.
I'm with you.
Yeah.
And Geraldo, or any non-Chinese player, knows you're not just up against the player. There's a mastermind in the corner as well.
3-1.
Wang Chuqin was pushed all the way there in that second game, and we've quite often seen when a Chinese player is pushed like that or loses a game, in fact, there quite often tends to be a response, a backlash in the following game.
Wang Chuqin is exactly that kind of guy as well that will not accept. They'll say, I don't need to deal with this. It's an arrogance, but it's also a sign of respect. It's a funny mixture. But he's the man who's clutched up at 2 world championships, the 2 world teams that he's actually really played. Yeah. He was on the bench in Halmstad in 2018, but Chengdu, playing the decider against Japan, wins it, and then against Korea.
He was in a tough spot then because he'd lost earlier.
Rare to see such a young player so relied upon.
Yeah, given that responsibility, especially when you've got two amazing players in Ma Long and Fan Chengdong. And remember, he actually took the number one spot for a couple of occasions last year, ahead of Fan Chengdong.
Yeah, that's right, before Ljubljana, because of a points reset.
Left 6-3.
You'd be calling him the best player in the world if he would have won that World Championships final.
Against Fan in Durban.
7.
Yeah. Fair point.
So basically a match away from being the best player in the world.
And actually it was a couple months after that he got that brief number one spot from Fan.
3-8.
He was the man that beat Fan Chengdong 4-0 in the final of the season end finals. First time Fan Chengdong had lost 4-0 since 2014. Did look a little bit tired though. Little fatty, but still not easy to dust him up like that, is it?
Not at all.
And it could be another fascinating encounter, that one.
8-5.
Yeah,
You just don't know at the moment when it comes to India-China clashes, because yesterday was Sri Jakula who gave Wang Manyu an almighty scare.
6-8.
I can't believe how good they've been recently.
Well, Giraldo's had a little bit of a fight back here. He's just two behind now.
7-8.
You know, he's pulling out stuff like this from time to time. And then there's a response from Wang Chuqi.
Got him where he wants him, he's got him in his jaws. Can he finish off his prey here, Wang Chuqi? Ooh, well.
Not quite yet.
The retouch of Wang Chuqi surprised me there, but actually it was a very nice shot. Did well, Giraldo, there to keep it tight again. And you can see Wang Chuqi actually appreciated that quality.
Right, yeah.
8-10.
So, two match points then for Wang Chuqi. One saved. Wang Chuqi is through to the next round.
11-9, game and match to Wang.
Fine performance, Wang Ruben.
Three games.
Oh, it's nice.